The Elizabeth Fry School in Plaistow on the night of February the 25th, one of more than 50 schools in London expected to suffer from fire damage this year. Elizabeth Fry is a special school catering for the handicapped and disabled. And last year, three of its pupils won major prizes in national fencing competitions. For the last 7 weeks, these champions have been deprived of their proper facilities and can only practice on a makeshift basis.
What did you feel when it burnt down, Salim?
Sick. It was a terrible thing that happened. It should never have happened.
Can't practice fencing anymore. Because the school's been gone, school's been burnt down now.
The only reason how we could actually train was at Elizabeth Fry School, because they had the proper curtains in there for us to practice, and all the fencing equipment they had, and that's all gone.
The cause of the blaze is still being investigated, but more than 60% of school fires are caused by arsonists. Today, the Fire Protection Association has been holding a seminar to persuade schools to take security more seriously.
Schools are vulnerable because they're a soft target. Most schools are set in their own grounds. They're surrounded by easily climbed fences, if they've got fences at all. They're unoccupied at night when most of the fires take place.
Well, my insurance company has paid out £150 million over the last 10 years purely in arson fires in schools. And last year alone, we had 33 arson fires at schools, which averaged over £630,000 each.
If it's your own property, you'd actually be reporting it. So with schools, we'd actually say treat it as your own and don't be afraid to report it. We don't mind if the report is done with good intent.
But at Elizabeth Fry School, the parents and pupils feel they've become the victims of an increase in school crime. Just 2 days ago, their planned temporary accommodation was seriously vandalised. This is Chris Morgan in Plaistow for Thames News.